life isn't fair. Have you ever had the situation where, you know, maybe when you were growing up as a kid, when it was time to clear the table, one of your siblings didn't do what they were supposed to, or they conveniently had to go to the washroom when it was their turn to do the dishwasher? Does it ever feel like you do more than anybody else and nobody appreciates you? Or you have a house party and you invite someone to your house party and they're chilling and have a good time and you're slaving in the kitchen and super stressed? Well, that kind of scenario is in the Bible. If you go to Luke chapter 10, this incredible little story of something that happened. Verse 38, Jesus enters a village and it tells us that Martha welcomed him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary who also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. Martha was distracted with much serving. She's stressed out. That word distracted actually means mentally troubled, like she's just consumed with all these details and stressed out. And it says of Mary, she sat at Jesus' feet. So we have a situation of a house party. Martha's doing all the work. There's a whole bunch of people because we know Jesus traveled with people. And it says Mary was also sitting at his feet. Okay, interesting. Martha invites him over. Yeah, come into my house. This is going to be amazing. And she's stressed out. Here's what it says. Verse 40, Martha was distracted with much serving, and she approached him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Therefore, tell her to help me. And Jesus answered and said to her, Martha, Martha, you're worried and troubled about many things, but one thing is needed, and Mary has chosen the good part which will not be taken away from her. First thing I want to say is that you can't control Jesus, even if you're a victim. Martha was a victim. She was distracted. He says she's worried and troubled. She's in a swirly world of too many details. And because she's a victim, her first words to Jesus is, don't you care? Listen, that's victim talk. Does anybody care about me? What about me? My life sucks. It's so hard. I have to do everything. That's victim talk, and it's not prayer. It doesn't work to get Jesus to do anything. So first thing, she thinks she's all alone. Classic victim. She thinks she doesn't have a choice. Second classic thing. Her anxiety is trying to control Jesus. Doesn't work. What does he say? You're worried and troubled about many things. One thing is needed, and Mary has chosen that good part, which will not be taken from her. What does it mean, that good part? That word part is portion. Mary chose, and that word chose is what it says about Jesus. When we become Christians, he chooses us. So Jesus is protecting Mary's choice of him. He says one thing is needed. You can't make excuses for all your stress, all your anxiety, all your busyness, in all the details of what you're doing when Jesus is saying one thing is needed. What is it? To sit at his feet. I'm sitting in a chair in the middle of my yard to tell you that one thing you need is to get alone and sit at the feet of Jesus and listen to him. Listen to his word. It's the one thing that's needed. People talk about, you need you time. You need downtime. Get a bottle of wine. Watch some videos. Just get alone by yourself. You need you time. I want to tell you, you need Jesus time. You need to get alone. The one thing you need, if you're like Martha, is Jesus. Now, he has guaranteed her seat at his feet is protected. Mary has reserved seating. There's no threat that anything is going to take her away from Jesus. Even all the demands and busyness of other people's stress is not going to pull her away from being with Jesus. Jesus wasn't mean to Martha. He just told her the truth. He diagnosed her, and it was awesome. So I bless you. In the middle of this crazy world, the one thing you need is not me time. It's Jesus time. Bye. Whoa! Girl, maybe. What are you doing in my chair?
Oh, she's shaking.
Okay. Now.
Done?
Yeah.